for a lot of kids these days, there's a distinct feel-bad factor in their lives. Some say this is reflected and maybe even reinforced by the music they listen to.
Well, Nirvana's lead singer Kurt Cobain obviously committed suicide. Actually, it was exactly a year ago this week. Amongst their other hits were songs like I Hate Myself and I Want to Die. Kind of negative, self-destructive lyrics like those may be hugely popular, but there is a backlash, and the upbeat words to this number, we think, are part of it.
Well, they won the Song for Europe contest last Friday with that very upbeat track. They are, of course, Love City Groove. Hi to you all, and congratulations. Hi.
Congratulations,
and
well done.
You're joining us sort of properly later on, so to speak, and you're going to sing for us and all the rest of it. But you actually wrote that track, didn't you? Because as a reaction to all the kind of negative, self-destructive stuff that was coming out of America, like Nirvana.
Yeah, sure.
Well, was it making you depressed?
Yeah, I mean, if everything was sort of dark, it's nothing's good basically if you've got one side of it. If there was always dark music all the time and just moody, you know, it's just, you get tired of it. It has its place, you know. No one wants to be happy all the time.
That's it, refreshing change, because I was turning on the radio all the time, on the television, and it was just always, you know, depressing subjects or, you know.
It's just very downbeat. Well, yeah. I have to say, I mean, when you take it in isolation, like that particular Nirvana track, I really like it, actually. Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, I don't really listen to the lyrics, if I don't
it's
understand
nice tune.
That.
Music.
It's a good tune, it's a good beat. Do you think, speaking for your generation, it's like a 1960s interview, that, isn't it? Speaking of your generation, do you think that the downbeat stuff is having a psychological effect on kids, teenagers? What do you think? I think it's a tough question, but just looking about. Yeah.
I think, you know, maybe they choose to like it and get into it because it's a reflection of what's going on around them. Mm. And I think all we're trying to do is just, you know, brighten things up a little.
Show them
a
little. Teenagers are always rebellious anyway.
Yeah, I mean, I think personally that it depends how they take it. You can like a good tune, and it could be a bad kind of tune to some people, but you can use it just to, you know, release certain energies.
Right.
Yeah. It doesn't mean you have to go out and actually, you know, do stuff like that.
And what you're saying is it actually spares you having those feelings. Then
yeah,
you
can release it through the music.
It's an escape for emotions, isn't it? And music is like universal emotion and the only universal written language.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think it is a vehicle for emotions, be they happy or sad.
Right.
And then it's down to the individual how they sort of control that and channel it.
Well, we'll talk to you about the Eurovision Song Contest later in the show, because you're singing for us after midday. But, I mean, it's a really cool track. I mean, it's being hyped as the, and in fact it is, probably the coolest entry ever. Are you happy about it?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have to say, we voted for you.
Oh, yes. And we got through.
Yes, we did.
Well, we'll catch you later on, right?
And we'll see you later.
Okay, so as I say, Love City Groove back in about an hour and a half.